In this video, we'd like to analyze the top 10 reasons why it could make more sense to colonize the Moon first before Mars. Now, of course, we could do both at the same time, but this video is meant to show the pros of colonizing the Moon as compared to Mars.
And in our next Friday's video, we will do the same for Mars, to make it fair. So then, what are the top 10 reasons why it would make more sense to colonize the Moon before Mars? Well, let's find out. So the old debate, Moon versus Mars. We know that Elon wants to aim for Mars, and this is totally understandable. Apart from Earth, Mars is the coolest planet in the solar system, and also the most suited for human habitation. But the only celestial body on which humans ever set foot upon is the Moon. And NASA is planning to return to the Moon with their Artemis program. So then what now? Moon or Mars? If we had to choose where to build our first colony, what would be the best reasons that speak for the Moon?
1. The Moon is much nearer. Well, this is of course kind of obvious, right? The Moon's distance varies between 362,600 kilometers in its perigee, so its nearest point to Earth, and 405,400 kilometers at its farthest, the so-called apogee. Compare that to Mars, with its nearest being 56 million kilometers to Earth, when Earth and Mars are aligned, and a staggering 401 million kilometers when Earth and Mars are at the opposite sides of the Sun. So even at its best, Mars is still on average more than 100 times further away from Earth than the Moon. Now this means several things. First, of course, we can reach the Moon much faster than Mars. Instead of 6 months of travel time, and let's be generous and say we'd find ways of accelerating that figure down to 3 months in the near future with better Starship propulsion. By the way, we also did a video on the most promising propulsion methods on how to reach Mars faster in this video here. So anyways, best case, we could reach Mars in 3 months, and even with the most insane hypothetical drive such as Vesemir, we'd still need 39 days. But for the time being, it will be probably 6 months.
Compare that to the Moon, which can be comfortably reached in 2 days. That's 100 times faster. This means if something goes wrong on the Moon, if some kind of accident happens, help from Earth is only 2 days away. For Mars, help is not only 6 months away, but you would have to wait for the next launch window to open, because Mars and Earth only align every 26 months, when a travel is even possible. So if shit hits the fan on Mars, you cannot really rely on any help from Mother Earth. For the Moon, there is no launch window necessary. And being much nearer, of course, means that the costs for reaching the Moon are much lower. Therefore, establishing a Moon base and living on the Moon is much cheaper than doing the same for Mars.
2. The Moon has great resources. Now sure, Mars has also great resources, but being so much nearer than Mars, we can actually use the Moon resources for benefits on Earth. The Moon hosts vast reserves of helium-3. In fact, it is thought to have a helium-3 concentration up to 70,000 times higher than on Earth, which could become very important in the future for potential use in a next-generation type of fusion reactor. But more short-term, rare Earth elements could be mined on the Moon, such as yttrium, which plays a key role for high-temperature superconductors, or neodymium, which is used for strong magnets.
Then, titanium is a really excellent metal, because it's extremely heat-resistant and very strong. Titanium is very abundant on the Moon in the mineral ammonite, especially at the Sea of Tranquility, where the concentration of titanium is 10 times as high as in Earth's crust. Then there are of course also large deposits of iron, aluminum, silicon, calcium, and magnesium, all of which play very important roles for industry applications. So a moon mining economy really makes a lot of sense, even more so because of the
3. Very low gravity on the moon. The moon's gravity is only 16.54% that of Earth. Compare that to Mars, which sports a 37.94% gravity of Earth, and you realize that the moon's gravity is not even half that of Mars. In fact, only 43.6% that of Mars. Now, while this of course might not be too good for the human body long term, but by the way, there are ways to overcome this, for example, rotating terrain habitats or genetic engineering. The lower gravity, of course, has huge benefits for orbital shipyards and reaching destinations in the solar system. Building starships, for example, in moon orbit from the previously mentioned lunar resources would be so much easier than building them on Earth. We could, for example, build a moon space elevator really much more easily than an Earth space elevator, which would require super strong carbon nanotube material. A moon elevator on the other side could be built with today's technology. Or even more easily, we could build
4. Mass drivers. They could be built on the moon much more easily than on Mars because of the lower gravity and the lacking of an atmosphere as compared to Mars, which has a thin atmosphere. So the lunar resources, titanium, iron and aluminum could be directly processed on the moon in moon factories. And even parts for Starship could be built in these factories. So how about a new Boca Chica on the moon? Imagine steel rings for Starship 2.0 being directly assembled on the moon from lunar resources and shot into orbit with mass drivers. The mass drivers are basically cannons that accelerate metal projectiles. So the payload, based on the electromagnetic induction effect, kind of like a Gauss gun or a railgun type of design, expanded to a larger scale. What is almost impossible here on Earth, due to the higher gravity and atmospheric friction, works really easily on the moon. And bam! Combining moon mining in situ resource utilization. So building parts directly from these resources on the moon and mass drivers, we would get
5. Moon orbital shipyards. Yes, turns out building giant starships in moon orbit would be much easier than on Earth and also easier than on Mars. The Enterprise D, which has been built according to the Star Trek universe at Utopia Planitia shipyards in Mars orbit, would have been more realistically built at Mare Tranquillitatis shipyards in moon orbit. We could build the next generation Starship 2.0 with its giant 18 meter diameter in moon orbit from lunar resources. And to make things even better, because the moon's gravity well is so much weaker than Earth's, we could leave from the moon for Mars much more easily than from Earth. This would thus result in faster travel times and even more so would allow us to reach destinations much further away than Mars, namely the outer solar system. From the moon, building a Mars base with moon resources would become a really much easier and cheaper solution than building a Mars base from Earth. And to make things even cooler, we could also make
6. Propellant from lunar regolith. You already know that we can easily extract oxygen and hydrogen from lunar regolith, which can be used to power lunar landers. The lunar landers can then launch back to moon orbit, rendezvous with a mothership, and finally bring us back to Earth. Even more interesting, it turns out that methane can also be extracted from lunar regolith in large enough quantities. This would of course be really nice for SpaceX's Starship. So Starship missions to Mars could start directly from the moon with propellant created from lunar regolith. Of course, in the future we could also shoot up propellant into moon orbit in propellant capsules with mass drivers and refuel the Starship 2.0s for their journey to Mars.
7. The moon has water ice. Yes, of course, Mars has more ice, but the fact that we have pretty large water ice reserves at the lunar South Pole came as a big surprise. Because this makes building a moon base at the lunar South Pole really easy, as all the necessary ingredients for human habitation can be won easily from the water ice.
8. Higher solar flux. Mars is on average 52.4% further away from the Sun than the Earth-Moon system. Therefore, the solar flux on the Moon is with a peak of 1,360 watts per square meter, more than twice of that of Mars' peak of 590 watts per square meter. So solar panels on the Moon would yield twice the electricity production as the same panels would yield on Mars. Also, there are no dust storms on the Moon to reduce the efficiency of the solar panels. And at Shackleton Crater, we could have solar power 24/7, because at the crater, the sun is never setting. On Mars, we will always have a Martian day and night.
9. Better suited for radio and optical astronomy. Because the Moon has no atmosphere, astronomy on the Moon would be a boon. A moon boon, so to speak. Okay, that also didn't have to be. And because of the low gravity, giant telescopes could be constructed, dwarfing even the largest ones on Earth. Even more, on the far side of the Moon, we could conduct absolutely unperturbed radio astronomy, as all the radio transmissions from Earth would be blocked out by the body of the Moon itself. This would allow for absolutely insane discoveries of new phenomena in the universe. Things we probably can't even imagine. And then finally...
10. Better suited for space tourism. If we combine all the previous points, it becomes pretty clear that the Moon is the space tourism target of choice, not Mars. You can have a nice vacation on the Moon for 1 or 2 weeks and then return to Earth. But doing the same with Mars is certainly not possible. So space tourism will at some point make the colonization of the Moon much more economically viable. And historically, tourism has always played a huge role on Earth in accessing new markets and new areas, and thus creating an infrastructure in previously uninhabited areas, leading to many jobs as well as new industries. On the Moon, the same will happen as soon as moon bases are established and moon mining gets going. Then this economy will be expanded to space tourism, which will bring huge amounts of fresh money into the young lunar industry.
So did we forget any important points, or is our top 10 list, you think, kind of complete? Let us know what you think in the comment section.
And we also made a video on how Starship could help us to establish our first moon base. You can check it out right here.
So then, thanks for watching the JS Space Report. And then I would say, on to the future!